What's going on, everybody? This is the Blockchain Backer, bringing you the latest cryptocurrency news and analysis. And welcome to a new week. Today, we're going to be taking a look over here at the total altcoin market cap price chart. I talked about this in yesterday's video, but we'll review this again. We'll peek over there at the Bitcoin price chart, and we'll talk about the Ripple XRP price chart, because I like what I'm seeing over there on the XRP price chart. If you caught yesterday's video, we were talking a lot about how double tap back tests and all that good stuff. I'll review that again here, but the correction that we're seeing over here happening throughout the whole market, it is typical after you do double tap on top of the all-time high that there is a pullback down into this price level. For a lot of people, this is their first time to be in corrections, right? We've had corrections of this size the whole way up, right? You can just look at how this thing has corrected. Sometimes they're longer, sometimes they're shorter, but from a magnitudes of size, nothing unusual is happening here in this market right now. So we'll dive into that. We'll talk about Bitcoin. We'll talk about the XRP price chart. This video actually is sponsored today. And I actually really have only ever accepted one sponsor on my channel ever. And that would be Unstoppable Domains. And tomorrow they are going to be running their premium domain sale. They've actually done three of these. I haven't covered them. I've just been so busy. But this thing does start tomorrow at 10 a.m. I've seen them do these. But you know what? People buy them and scoop them all up. Tomorrow's their finance sale. So they're going to be selling a lot of the finance named domains. So anything .crypto. For me, I use these domains because I tie like my addresses to them. So I can put like my XRP address and I can put my Ethereum, my Litecoin, my Bitcoin address all into one. So that way anybody can just type in bcbacker.crypto and then just send it to me, so long as they're using a compatible wallet like Coinbase wallet. But anywho, they've had a lot of success with these and people are buying them up, and you know, you do whatever you want with them, right? Resell them, or you can go ahead and store them for yourself for later. With the growing rise of cryptocurrency and the popularity, NFTs, all that stuff, we've seen this grow tremendously. But this sale will be happening tomorrow at 10 a.m. Pacific, 1 p.m. Eastern time. There's always a link in the description of my videos to Unstoppable Domains. This is my affiliate link where you can sign up and get your account. So when the stuff does go live tomorrow, you'd want to already have your account set up if you intend on buying any of them. But you can check them out by visiting the link in the description of this video. And of course, they have tons of other domains in there too. If you just wanted to get something with your name or your username and create your own, you could do that too outside of the premium domain sale. But I know that's a big event for them. I'll remind you guys of that again tomorrow. But moving along, throughout the weekend, we saw a big fall over here in the total altcoin market cap and in the Bitcoin price, with the altcoin market falling 22%. We have been in a recovery for the last 24 hours with kind of a retracement. So at this point, is this thing going to hold? For me, it's looking pretty optimistic. I look at it from a structural standpoint. I was saying, man, it's starting to look kind of like a Wyckoff accumulation to me, especially when I looked over at Bitcoin, because what we saw immediately was a big throwback, which is an automatic rally. It wasn't as dramatic over here on Coinbase, but it was an automatic rally. And then all yesterday afternoon, as we were down here, I was thinking to myself, okay, what we have to do is we have to come up above this price level right in here. And that's typically what we'll see. And then we'll see it kind of make a scary sell-off again another time back down into this price level. But so long as we reach up above here, then we're looking like a Wyckoff accumulation. So it's looking positive to me. In yesterday's video, I talked about, you know, the potential that, you know, Bitcoin's price is really high. The top of it is going to be coming in at some point based on my analysis. Now, you have to understand, I have some of the lowest price targets throughout all of crypto, right? You go look online, you're going to see price targets of insanity everywhere, right? I keep my targets pretty low to try to keep my realistic expectations in check. For me, I exit 65% by the time we get to whatever target that I have. Then I'm willing to let the rest ride. David Schwartz caught a lot of flack a couple of days ago on the 13th when he said, this is probably going to be my least popular tweet ever, but if you have life-changing amounts of cryptocurrency, please take some time to seriously consider selling some to reduce your risk and exposure. This is not any kind of prediction about what the markets will do. In the end, I always say I'm going to sell 65% regardless of if the price is going to go significantly higher, because by the time we get to where my portfolio is where it's at, once I reach specific targets, at that point, I can't afford to lose that amount of money anymore. When I invested an amount of money I could lose. It would hurt, but not an amount that would completely devastate me and ruin my life. By the time the price targets get really high, you can say it's all on paper all you want, but you can make it real. And at that point, I can't afford to lose that much money. So I keep my targets pretty low, and that's where I sit. That's where I let go of 65%. Now, when I was making my targets and talking about my targets several months ago, those were all thought to be pipe dreams and never possible, but now they're all considered to be low. I don't think anybody ever expected Ethereum Classic to go hit its all-time high, and I'll be the first to admit I'm pretty impressed. But in the end, Bitcoin's price is very high, so I'm going to be looking for a top coming in for Bitcoin in here. If it wants to surpass it and go significantly higher, by all means, go for it. But over the coming weeks and maybe even months, who knows? The things I'm really looking for is for that Bitcoin top to come in. But it also means that we're going to be having a really exciting time in the altcoin market if the cryptocurrency market continues to do what it's done in the past, which up until this point in our current cycle, it has, right? Bitcoin breaking out first, leading the way, getting up near the top of the Fib extensions, and then the altcoin market taking off. I think Dogecoin's a really good example of that. This is all happening here at the end of the Bitcoin cycle. Ethereum Classic, hello, Ethereum Classic, hitting its all-time high here at this time period. Things are rocking and rolling in the altcoin market. And I think it's a very blatant, obvious sign that the Bitcoin top is coming in because we spent enough time reviewing this, right? If this was something that we just kind of came up on a whim or something like that, the thing is, we've been talking about this for like 6 or 8 months at this point, maybe even longer, maybe 10 months at this point. Here's that infamous tweet we haven't talked about in a little while since on August 28th of 2020. Imagine this hypothetical scenario playing out where Bitcoin breaks out into a new all-time high, 20,000, 30,000, 40,000, 50,000. FOMO for Bitcoin is insane and on financial media everywhere. XRP stays at 30 cents the entire time this is happening. What would you do? Right? Creating this scenario and understanding that we've seen this before. And that's exactly how it played out, right? XRP stayed down there in the 30s and 40s while Bitcoin went running up to 50,000. But here we were talking about it back when Bitcoin was 11,500, talking about it getting to 50,000 and XRP not doing anything. And that's because we've seen this before in the cycles before. And so I think it's just real important to have, you know, for me in particular, right? I'm not a financial advisor. It's not investment advice, but I share everything that I look at with you guys so you can see things from my perspective. And so when I was looking way out into the future back in, you know, August to say, what have we seen before? And we've seen that Bitcoin can take off and it gets up near these particular price levels. And that's when the altcoin market takes off. Here we are in 2021. We've been seeing all that craziness happening in March and April, right? So in the end, for me, I know those big moments are going to be coming relatively soon. And, you know, for a lot of people, time is all about, you know, perception, right? What does relatively soon mean? Does that mean a day? Does that mean a week? Does it mean a month? Does it mean 6 months? And that's going to be in the eye of the beholder. I've been in the cryptocurrency market for several years. I went through the entire bear market. So my perception of what time is means it's relatively short. I would assume within a couple of months, we will have hit these top targets and that this total altcoin market cap will have even reached out further. And at the top of Bitcoin will likely have already come in by then. So I'm on edge. I'm in full-blown exit plan mode. I'm having to stay on my toes and be prepared. And that is that I won't be caught by surprise if Bitcoin ever does begin to crash because of how high we have gotten. And so then I say to myself, if Bitcoin did start to crash because we are up so high, what do I do? Well, I have to look to the past to use as my reference point and my guide for how this market has operated. Because it has been like having a cheat sheet by looking into the past and applying that to present and attempting to forecast the future. It has worked incredibly well. And barring any type of black swan event where there's some type of government situation like we saw with the SEC and XRP, I'm going to continue assuming we'll just operate the way the crypto market has always operated. And that altcoins will continue to march significantly higher. The opportunity in Bitcoin is dismal to non-existent, and that after Bitcoin does have its initial crash, which tends to be 40 to 50% in an initial straight down crash after the top does come in, if we were to have some type of continued rise higher, it usually shows a straight line down crash followed by a retracement. And in each cycle, just like we have over here, This retracement is the mark of the end of the alt season. Throughout history and timing, not all of them top here. They can top at different times, but typically all of the last ones who were the laggards and the ones who just didn't get the job done before Bitcoin got to its top, they finish their alt seasons right in here after Bitcoin has already crashed and then in the retrace. And so for me, I have all my targets picked out on, you know, where I want to sell 65% of my cryptocurrencies at for each individual cryptocurrency. But what if there's a big surprise in the market? What if those targets aren't going to get hit? This is that moment right in here into that retrace where I just have to pull the plug, right? And that's just part of my exit plan that, you know, if the targets don't hit, then that's just life. I have to find some other backup strategy for me. And it's going to be during that retracement rally where I would say it's time for me to go ahead and de-risk. Because if we look to the past, and here's the 2017 bull run of the cryptocurrency market, we can see where Bitcoin's top came in. And then we can also see where the total altcoin market cap's top came in, right? You can see that the altcoin market ended up having its top come in after the retracement. So Bitcoin did its big crash from $20,000 down to $11,000. Then it was the retracement back to $17,000 that ended up marking the top of the altcoin market. Now, each altcoin operates differently, right? So some of them will, some of them won't. But for me, it's this moment in time where if Bitcoin shows some monstrous crash, this is where I've got to do my de-risking at, regardless of if it's hit price targets or not. Hopefully, Bitcoin just moves to the upside. We get into those 70s and those $80,000 price levels. The altcoin market marches along with it, and all of this is just additional worry that was unnecessary. But I think talking about all these things is really great, because eventually, that moment will show up. It has shown up every time. It has shown up in every bubble. But showing those things and understanding that, hey, Bitcoin's up there near the top, looking at probably something happening there at some point pretty soon, and the Bitcoin's not going to go significantly higher than what it is. And then we look over here at the altcoin market and understanding that altcoins have a tendency to continue rising even after the Bitcoin bubble has popped. We can see that there's still room left in the altcoins, and history shows us that those altcoins keep going. So having expectations that these prices are going to go higher, I keep those expectations because I've seen it in the past. I see measurements that take me out there, and that's the way I'm going to play my cards. And then I come on over here to this bad boy, the Ripple XRP price chart, because I know a lot of people want to see this, and I'm excited to talk about this because I'm really happy now that I've gotten an opportunity to review where this rejection came in for XRP, where the support levels are coming in. And as you guys know, we keep talking about this being the retracement rally prior to Bitcoin collapsing at the end of 2018. That was also the level that was very significant in the 2015, 16, 17 bull run for Bitcoin and for XRP, that rally was really an important measurement. And that here we are finding a rejection up here at this 702. And when we come back and we grab this previous fractal, we overlay it on top of it. We can go ahead and put that rejection right there at that 702. How high does it get us out? It gets us out right to target. So what does that number happen to be? It happens to be there at $11, right? So I keep talking about $10 to $13. That's where I do a lot of my de-risking on XRP at. Hopefully the price goes to the moon. I know a lot of people are calling for $100, $1,000, $10,000. I have absolutely no reasonable expectations of any of those price numbers. All of my expectations and my plans revolve around getting here to this $10, right? Or in this case, it shows 11. But back when XRP was, you know, 17 cents, 15 cents, 22 and a half cents, the big wonder was that, is that a reasonable number? Is that realistic, right? And the closer we get to it, as we got to, you know, $1.80, $1.90, that number didn't sound realistic to a lot of people anymore, right? When greed really sets in, people start saying, that's not going to happen. We're going to 60, we're going to 100, we're going to 1,000, 10 bucks. Really, you still believe that? You need to justify yourself. You need to validate your justifications and reasonings on why that's the number, because I'm seeing everybody tell me it's going way higher. Emotions get hot, man. Everybody is going to have their own plan and their own targets. I can't tell you what's going to happen. I know people love to call me legend and from the future, the man, the myth, the legend. I'm just a regular person like all of you, but I spend a lot of time in these charts, right? And so I've come up with my own plans and I've shared them with you. The future will tell whether or not they're right or wrong. But that's my plan. That's where I'm going to. That's where I let go of 65%. And, you know, what happens if Bitcoin completely collapses on itself, right? What if we go into that retracement rally and XRP only gets to $5 in that retracement rally when Bitcoin, you know, pulls back up? What do I do? the decision might have to get made even lower. But I really like the way this chart looks. It makes me feel good. It makes me have comfort in that we found a really perfect place for us to have that rejection come in at, right there at that 702. And then that previous fractal takes us out completely perfectly to the full Fibonacci extension by measuring, by using the rally prior to Bitcoin capitulating, right? How ironic is that? So for a lot of people, this is tough times, right? Going through a correction when things get really exciting. And that's just typically how markets work. People don't want to come into markets when they're really bear markets, right? When we were in the bear market, it was about having that faith and that conviction and buying into the depths of despair and dreaming of the days that things like this would happen and having that vision to the future that it was going to come. Then as it comes, the general public tends to pile in. Then a lot of them will get tested. A lot of them will get shooken out in here because this is the most volatile market in the world. We see 50% ups and 50% downs, and those can happen in days. That's how you get these thousands of percent rises that we see in things like Dogecoin, right? Right. And just this last week, right, Dogecoin has risen 700%. But what also did Dogecoin do during this time? Dogecoin also lost 50% in that time period. With these massive rises comes these massive falls. And then Dogecoin has now risen again another 90%, and then today fallen another 15%. For most people, that's very difficult volatility to be able to handle. And so a lot of people just won't make it. And just like right now, in a matter of a couple of minutes, we just watched a big old fall happen right here on XRP as we're moving along in here, along with the rest of the market. So we're in a volatile moment. The things that I always look out for in these times are that, one, the sentiment of the market tends to change at these times. That fun, that euphoria, that feel-good drug that everybody has tends to fade. And so what happens when that fades is that sentiment changes amongst the community. All the excitement on social media fades, the excitement in YouTube videos fade, the excitement on financial media disappears as prices go lower and people start becoming worried. And then as they become worried and fearful, the narrative in the media changes, and then suddenly negative events start occurring. So you have things stacking on top of each other, just like we saw in the move to the upside. Prices are rising, prices are excited, positive news happening, the sentiment, excitement. Then as prices start turning to the downside, fear, panic, negative news, optimism lost. And that is how markets work. Unfortunately, like we're just talking about with experience, right? We've learned that over time, right? That's just how these things have always worked. When the prices get high, people get excited. When the prices get low, people get scared. And people become real tight with their money at the bottom, right? Everybody at the top is saying, I'm waiting for a pullback. Yeah, I'm going to buy like crazy when that pullback happens. Then the pullback happens and they say, well, I'm going to wait just a little bit more. And that's what always happens. But otherwise, we could see XRP go deeper. That's what we've seen happen in the past. As for me, I just sit back and wait. Doesn't bother me. I have my vision on the big prize and the next move to the next level up. But we'll peek right back over here at Bitcoin, because at the beginning of the video, we were talking about it moving down to the downside. Here we go. We're in it. We'll see if this thing Wyckoff accumulates and can find some support in here. But all right, I'm going to go ahead and wrap this thing up. You guys can check out my website over here. It's bcbacker.com. This is my course where I deep dive into the previous Bitcoin bull runs and the different altcoin market cycles, tying them all together to show how they've worked in the past. Talk about different tools and indicators over here on TradingView, Fibonacci analysis. Talk about forecasting, talk about rebalancing percentages, mathematics. And of course, I talk about my different exit plans in here. I have included some recent updates and I have an update way down in here. And you can check this out over here on bcbacker.com. You can follow me over here on Twitter at bcbacker. Don't forget to get your Unstoppable Domains account set up for tomorrow's premium domain NFT sale that starts at 10 a.m. Pacific time, 1 p.m. Eastern time. You can find my affiliate link in the description of all of my videos to Unstoppable Domains. And well, as we head into this wild and wacky week of volatility, I hope that you guys had a great weekend. So thank you so much for watching my channel. If you could, please like this video and give it a thumbs up. If you're new to the channel, please subscribe and hit the notification bell so you can be notified of when I create new content and when I go live. As always, this is not investment advice and I am not a financial advisor. But if you ever need a pick-me-up or a little bit of reassurance, just remember that the blockchain backers got your back. Have a good one.